So orangutan, they are arboreal apes. So basically in the wild, they hardly come into the forest floor at all. It's because all the food that they need up there in the forest canopies. And also it's quite good of them as well to keep them safe from their predators, like for example tigers. We do have tigers in Sumatra and large python, and group of wild boar also could kill them. And of course it's crocodile when they come across to the river side in the long, long dry season. Also, orangutan, they are the largest living mammals and the only great apes found in Asia. Thousands of years ago, their population is quite a lot. But unfortunately, today, their population only found on the two islands of Borneo and Sumatra. And the word orangutan in Indonesian language or Malays means persons of the forest, as they spend the majority of their time in the forest canopies. And if you look at them, they have extra long and flexible limbs, which make them perfectly adapted to move around in the trees. Unlike any other great apes, for example like chimpanzee or gorilla, where they are in the wild, they live in a group. Orangutan in the wild, they live solitaries. Male orangutan, they live exclusively solitary lifestyle, and basically they are only coming together to female for mating. And male orangutan, they will never tolerate company of other male, and they will fight over the territories. Female, however, they are kind of more sociable. They've been seen in a small family unit sharing fruiting trees with other individuals. So orangutan, they can actually live happily together in a small group in captive setting like this, as long as fully mature males are kept apart. In the wild, orangutan, they can live up to around 45 years, and even longer in captivity like this with all the cares and medications, and plus there is no threat for them. And reaching their sexual maturity around the age of 11 to 15 years old, and female orangutan, they usually give birth to single infant after a gestation period 8.5 months, and the babies, they often stay with their mother for 6 to 8 years. And of course, during this time, they learn all the skill needed for life in the forest. And if they are female, it's very important to learn how to handle the babies. And due to this orangutan solitary nature, babies, they do need to learn pretty much everything before they leave their mothers. So here at the park, guys, at Monkey World, we have 15 orangutan, and we kept them into 3 groups. And this group behind me here is nursery's group. We have 7 orangutan here in this house in total. And today is the one who got access to enclosure is 3 babies and 1 female adult. And this nursery's group here, guys, this is the place, place for many babies from all over the world whose their mother passed away or they're rejected by their mothers. We always look after them in here. So let me introduce you first, the one who got access in the enclosure. This boy here, he is 2.5 years old, and he is, unfortunately, his mother passed away. It's because he couldn't digest food properly, so we handed him, and his name is Bulu Mata. And that female over there, that's Roro, and she smuggled from the wild really young age as well, and we got her actually from Pintung Rescue Center in Taiwan. And Roro, at the moment, she is acting as a foster mom for our newest arrival, which is this one, Mimi. And she is only 1 year and 9 months. And Roro, at the moment, actually her foster mom. And every night, we always keep Mimi and Roro sleep together. And the other young girl over there is Rika. And Rika, she's also 2.5. And Rika's mother unfortunately rejected her, and we got her from Berlin Zoo. And yeah, the one inside, we have Oshin inside. Oshin, she's an adult female orangutan now, and she's 20 years old. And Oshin, we got her from South Africa. She came to us here in 2010. When Oshin came here, she was only 12 years old girl, but she weighed over 100 kilos, which is almost heavier than our fully adult male ones next door. And now, Oshin, she lost over 50 kilos just from eating right food and playing with the baby. So when Oshin came here, she didn't realize that she's an orangutan. She thinks that she's human babies because rest of her life she's been living with human. And also this lady is the one who used to look after her, often dress her up. And yeah, Oshin now she's realized that she's an orangutan after literally that we rescued Sylvester. When we got Sylvester, we introduced Sylvester straight to Oshin and they born really, really good relationship. Our second group guys is Tuan's group. Tuan, he is an adult male orangutan. So we estimated Tuan, he is about 35 to 40 years old. Tuan himself, he smuggled from the wild really, really young age. And local people in Borneo kill his mom basically just to get him to sell him to this Taiwanese fisherman. And this Taiwanese fisherman, often they came to Borneo. So I'm from Borneo myself. Often they came to Borneo, they love buying baby orangutan, baby gibbon or baby macaque. Basically just to entertain them on the boat while they are catching fish. And Tuan is one of them. And then this Taiwanese fisherman, when they got to Taiwan itself, sold Tuan back to the black market. So basically they make double profit from the fish, the one that they caught, and also from the orangutan Tuan. So yeah, like any other great apes guys, male orangutan they are bigger and stronger than female. Fully adult male, for example, like Tuan, he got this large cheek pad around his face.